Hello and God bless you. This is Bishop Kenyon once again, and welcome to Relationship 101. As you notice, I have the same shirt that I had on yesterday, but I recorded both of these the same day, so I do change my shirts just in case you had any questions about that. Amen? Listen, earlier we talked about dating and the purpose of dating. Once again, the purpose of dating is for you to get as much information as you can, because unfortunately what often happens is people get married, and then when you get married, it's like the person starts unpacking the baggage. They had this baggage before you started dating, but because you moved too fast, there were things that you did not see. While on that point, let me say this. The operative word for dating, I need to charge you all for telling you this, because this will help somebody. The operative word for dating, aside from gathering the information, as a matter of fact, it will facilitate the accumulation of information. But the operative word, rather, is slow. Slow. You must move slowly. What happens oftentimes is there are certain things about this person you like. From a man's perspective, she may be fine. She may walk the way you like for her to walk. She's got big legs and you like big legs. But brother, let me tell you something. There's more to her than being fine and big legs. That's only a fraction of everything about this woman. From the female perspective, you might say he is fine. He's tall, dark, and handsome. Maybe he has hair, which is something I cannot say I have right now, but I used to have hair. But let me tell you, sisters, there's a lot more to that brother that you need to know other than he's fine, tall, dark, and handsome. Because what you see is only a fragment of what there is to be known about this person. And in order to get as much information as you can, you must move slowly. Slowly. When you're driving, if you're driving down the expressway doing 80 miles an hour, because of the speed that you're going, there are some things in the periphery that you may not be able to see because you're passing them so quickly. But if you slow down, you'll be able to see more. I want you to hear me. And the same is true within the context of dating. The slower you go, the more you will see. And many of you who are watching this right now, I'm sure that if you're honest with yourself, you will say that many of the mistakes I made in relationship was because I moved too fast. And in moving too fast, I didn't get enough information that I needed to know about this person. You got to keep your emotions in check. You got to keep your mind in check. You got to keep that line open with God. You got to stay in the Word of God. Stay fasted up. Stay prayed up. Because what can happen is once you get in a relationship, you can become so swept up in the relationship that you're not as cognizant of various things that you need to be aware of because everything is moving so fast. But I want to tell you something. If you want to save yourself a lot of hurt, if you want to save yourself a lot of emotional pain, I encourage you to slow down. Slow down. Most of the time, when you look at your bad relationships, if you're honest with yourself, now certainly there are exceptions to the rule, but most times people make wrong decisions about relationships because you move too fast. So I want to encourage you, slow down, slow down. You can profoundly affect your relational future if you slow down in the present. I know some of you watching, you're tired of going into these vacillating relationships, tired of getting into bad relationships, and then sometimes you can go through bad relationships and you can say, if you're a man, you can say, well, there are no good women out there. If you're a woman, you can say there are no good men out there. Well, listen, if you keep getting in bad relationships, maybe you need to pay closer attention to the criteria that you are using to get involved with people. Maybe there are some things that you need to change about your selection process. Because many times what can end up happening is you end up with the same person in a different body. It seems like the same kind of person is attracted to you. So that says to me, you have to change your process, change your criteria that you use for getting in relationships with people, because there is no pain like pain that is associated with relationships, breakups or hurt. It seems to linger. It can make you depressed. And this is what I want to help you avoid, because I don't want to see you go through that. All right? So the word is slow down. I want you to say it to yourself. I have to slow down. The slower you go, the more you will know. God bless you once again. This is Bishop Kenyon. Thank you for watching us today. And I want to encourage you to tell your friends and your family members about Relationship 101. And if you feel led of the Lord and this is beneficial to you, I want you to hit that donate tab and just give us an offering of any size. Also, I want you to hit the button that says, let Bishop know you stopped by, and send me any questions that you may have, because I'll be more than happy to answer your question. God bless you. This is Bishop Kenyon saying, I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. The Lord bless you now.